Jim Bianco, special guest today. Jim, we have a chart. I just love following your chart. You update it every week as central banks update what holdings they have and the size of their balance sheet. Hopefully viewers are looking. Explain this chart of cumulative central bank balances, and what's that other line on it?
So you take all of the central bank balance sheets, convert them to dollars, and add them up. And I got the idea from you, your famous line that all central bank stimulus is fungible, so let's add them all together. But because I convert them to dollars, I show the dollar index on it too. So the decline that we've had is because the dollar is strengthened, and that would reduce the amount of conversions that you have. You strip out the dollar effects, there's been no decline in central bank balance sheets. Worldwide central bank stimulus, even though the Fed has been pulling back, is not down because the ECB and the Bank of Japan continue to stimulate to more than offset it.
So it's no coincidence, if you look at that chart, people, that the basically right around the beginning of the year to where we are now, balance sheet numbers are about the same, and the dollar index is about the same.
Exactly, meaning that there's a lot of stimulus left in the market. And it goes to the point that I've argued that the Fed got a free pass.
They played musical chairs in essence, but we have a spot reserved for us, is what you're saying.
Yes, they got to reduce their balance sheet and tighten because the other central banks have offset them. The big decision for quantitative tightening in the markets is when the ECB and Mario Draghi decide to step away from the table as well too, because then that global balance sheet number could start to decline. And I think that will give markets more turbulence than looking at just one central bank alone. So this week we've got all three central banks having their meetings. The third most important meeting this week might be the Fed, and the most important might be the ECB tomorrow.
Yes, now Bank of Japan did a little tweaking around the edges. I walked away and I said it earlier. The best phrase I heard was a trader saying they're tinkering with how they're tinkering, but it certainly doesn't look like they're in any respect going to be pulling back.
Exactly, so they're going to keep adding stimulus. All stimulus is
fungible.
Even
Jamie Dimon yesterday, that great interview with Will Frost, talked about one of the things that keeps him up at night is the unwinding of the balance sheets and all the policies. You know, the big banks never complained when it was aiding them, but as this reverses, there's going to be bumps. All right, another topic, interest on reserves. A boring topic, I discuss it with a lot of ex-Fed governors, but you said something to me that floored me. Listen to this.
If we get two more rate hikes this year, as everybody expects, next year, nearly 20% of bank profits will be interest on excess reserves paid by the Federal Reserve to the banks. And that could potentially become a big political issue. Why are we giving them this giant subsidy?
Jeb Hensarling is already, and I had him on, a little bugged by this notion. I think that statistic, Jeb, are you listening?